Okay, so for summing amplifier, normally the question do not ask about calculating the gain. Normally the question will ask to compute the output voltage, alright, because you have multiple inputs. Okay, so you are going to calculate what is V out. So it uses the concept of the inverting configuration, where you can see here. Okay, so this time the non-inverting is grounded, right, and the inputs are all fed to the inverting terminal. Okay, so we know that this is directly connected to ground, which means that this node is zero. This node is 0 volt, which means that this node, okay, all these three nodes are also 0 volt. Okay, so same thing, we're going to use the concept of the KCL, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 currents. So you can see here I have 5 currents. So I1 corresponds to this branch. Okay, so I2 for this branch, I3 is for this branch, and I4 is the current flowing through this RF. Okay, and we know that the second characteristic is no current into the op amp, so that is the 0 ampere current. Okay, so the branch current equation for I1, just one example, so the V input 1 minus 0 over R1 is your I1. So you continue to do the branch current equation, okay, and then don't forget the I4 will be 0 minus V out over RF. Okay, so as you rearrange the branch current equation, you will get this equation. So as I mentioned just now, you are calculating the output voltage. So for example, this is the equation if you have 3 input signal. So if you have only 2, then this is your output voltage equation. As long as the number of input signal is more than 1, you are going to deal with a summing amplifier. Okay, so for this example here, you are asked to design a summing amplifier as shown in figure to produce a specific output signal such that this is the output signal, and you are given 2 input signals, a DC and a cosine wave, right? And you are also given the RF equivalent to 10 kilo ohm, right? So when the question asks about design, it means that you are going to find what are the values of the resistor. Okay, so because you are only having 2 input signals, means that you're going to use this equation here. Okay, so if I go to the next slide, okay, you can see here, so the equation has only considered the 2 inputs, right? And so the first input is minus 1 and the second input is the cosine wave. So you are going to find what is R1 and R2 because the question says design. So you are given the output voltage here, okay, and you just multiply RF over R1, okay, as this equation here, and then you multiply this with the cosine wave and you get this term. Now this is just one equation with 2 unknowns because you don't know what is R1 and R2. However, mathematically you can still get 2 equations because you just compare the term on the left with the term on the right and you can get the answer. So the other one is the term cosine, the cosine wave term. You can compare the first number before the cosine word comes out. So I match these 2, RF over R1 is 1.25 and I will get 8 kilo ohm. And if I compare this 2.5 with RF over R2 multiply with 0.5, you have to include the 0.5 as well because the box is up to the cosine wave. Okay, so you have to take all the box before the cosine wave. Okay, so this is what I have done, and I will get the answer R2 equivalent to 2 kilo ohm and R1 is 8 kilo ohm. So that's how you design your summing amplifier, right? Okay, so as a summary, this is the equations that you need to remember for your chapter 8. Okay, but remember, if you do not sure what kind of configuration it is, to go back to the two characteristics and derive the equation using nodal analysis. Okay. Okay, so I would like to show you some other examples that I have in the slide. So this is an example of a cascaded op-amp, but it's actually very simple. Okay, so this question asks you to find what is the input given what is the output voltage. So calculate the input voltage if the final output V out here is 10.08 volt. So this is where your knowledge to identify the type of configuration is useful. So for example, you can see for this one is an inverting because this is grounded and the input signal is fed to the inverting terminal here. So just label the nodes as VB. So this VB is the input signal for this inverting, and you have to work backwards. Okay, so V out over VB is minus R2 over R1. Okay, so I get what is VB by using this minus R2 over R1. So this second configuration is also inverting because this node is grounded, and another node here I label as VA will be the input fed to the inverting terminal, and this is your R2 and R1. So you can see here minus R2 over R1 is the voltage gain. So VB is the output for this op-amp. So VB over VA is minus 5 over 5. And you will get VA equivalent to 0.504 volt. Now the last configuration is non-inverting. The input voltage is fed to the non-inverting terminal, and the inverting terminal is connected to this R1, and this is R2, and this is 0 volt. Okay, and eventually you will get what is the input signal. Of course, you can use the derivation method, but it may be taking too much time. Okay, the next question, also a cascaded op-amp. Okay, so this is what? Okay, so this is also inverting because you can see this is grounded and the input signal is fed to the inverting terminal. So this second one can be tricky for some of you. Okay, but you can see that this is grounded and this is another input. So this is input number one and this is input number two. So definitely this is a summing amplifier. So the question asks you to calculate V out if V1 and V2 is 700 millivolt. So the first step is just finding what is VA. VA is the output voltage for the inverting amplifier. So minus R2 over R1, 500 over 250 multiply with 0.7. Okay, so basically I compute this 700 millivolt into volt, and this is my voltage VA. So VA is the first input and this is the other input using the summing amplifier equation, and you get the output voltage V0 equivalent to 0 volt. Okay, so now we have come to the final example for this chapter. So at first glance, it is quite difficult for me to understand what kind of configuration this is. So because of that, I will do the derivation method. Okay, all right. So firstly, what are the two characteristics? The voltage here and the voltage over here must be the same, and that there is no current inside the op-amp. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is you need to assign the current direction. So let's say I assign this one is going in and this one is going out, and for this branch is also going out, and we already know that the current here is 0. Okay, so we start with the KCL equation. Alright, so if I assign like this, this is I1, I2, I3 minus 0. Okay, so that's my KCL equation. And then I proceed with the branch current equation as follows. So Vs minus 0 over Rs. So why Vs minus 0? Because this node is directly connected to ground, therefore this node is also 0 volt. Okay, so back to the equation, Vs minus 0 over Rs, and then this node is 0, and for this current 0 minus 0, so this also grounded, so this also 0 volt. So 0 minus 0 over R1. Okay, okay, let me, okay, over R1. And then you have this branch, 0 minus V out over RF. Okay, then now I will put in the values. Right, so 1.5 over 1.5 minus, so I will basically just ignore this term because the answer is 0. So minus 0 minus V out, so I'm left with this, and RF is 3 kilo ohm. So next, 1.5 over 1.5 is 1, so this multiply becomes plus. So V out over 3 equivalent to 0 volt, and then I will have V out equivalent to minus 3. So that's how I get the answer, minus 3 volt. Okay, brothers and sisters, that's the end of chapter 8. Oh my God, that is so tiring, because I really want you to understand the concept of op-amp, and I hope that you understand about nodal analysis much better now. Okay, so Assalamualaikum. I see you guys later in class. Bye.